Where is Mr. Ram? Grandpa has got to be in here somewhere. Probably 15, 20 ewes and lambs we've seen so far. 7 rams. 1 kind of close, but just not there yet. So the search continues. Gotta be in here somewhere. Been watching a couple boys up there in the nasties. Haven't been able to get any glass on them yet. They are in the nasties. I do see a white dot up there. Well, maybe we better do some glass. Well, we finally spotted him up there, and of course he's just a half curl little banana head. He's learning the way of the nasties. He's with a buddy up there, so with any luck, he's got some real headgear. Ah, the wonderful ups and downs of sheep hunting. At least we have a beautiful day. It's not raining like yesterday. Nice day for a walk in the mountains. Another little wiggy's crossing. Swift. Better than wet feet. Looks like Sasquatch. Avalanche ice. RJ's gonna sleep in there tonight. Got another gaggle of ewes and lambs up there. We could just not find the boys. Nice to know there's lots of lambs around though. Finally spotted a ram up around the corner. Looks like he's got some headgear that might go. RJ keeps dragging me farther and farther up in these darn mountains. Oh my goodness. He's up in a little bit of nasty, but I think we can get to him. Kind of hidden there. We're trying to do our best to stay out of sight. Pretty soon we're going to get exposed as we climb up in there. So hopefully, any luck, we got ourselves a legal ram at least to go hang out with today. Bit of a canyon to come up through here. Not too bad. This is where we pulled RJ's monster ram out 3 seasons ago. Kind of walked out of here in the dark. Hopefully we do not do that again. Let's go see what we got. Search continues. good tonight. Climbed up to GPS at 6,800 feet. A couple thousand feet from our tent. Too bad for a couple old guys. Looking sexy in his underwear today. Took a little weather, Dave. Clouds are super low. You still can't understand how that ram duped us in the fog. Like RJ says, gorillas in the mist. Not quite sure what happened, but he was there 1 minute. Fog came in, we were hunkered down for 30, 45 minutes in the fog, we couldn't see anything, and finally cleared. Sheep was gone. Kind of took a weather day. Hopefully the high pressure comes back in and clouds lift so we can go back up and see if we can't find them. Get all our stuff dried out. Daily chores of sheep hunting. RJ's been a trooper and been pumping most of it. Great time on our walking route today. We got to witness a big old grizzly bear chasing a ewe and a lamb way up into the nasties. Little National Geo moment. Hooray for the ewe and the lamb, though. They duped that little grizzly bear. He just kept going higher into the nasties. Never seen a grizzly bear go so high in the nasties. Hopefully he stays away from our tent. Got back just in time to get some water and start getting comfortable for the late afternoon, early evening. Just another shower here. Amazing what a little piece of nylon will do for protection. I think this is the reason my lovely wife doesn't want to go sheep hunting with me. Dry in here though. Not quite the Arctic oven. This is all we get when we gotta carry it on our back. Right there is some stinky meat right there. It's fixing to be about dinner time here though. Again, I've been talking about porterhouse and legs off. Good times. I've always wanted to get up this pass and see to the east. Just because we can. We're going to pop out at about 7,000 feet. Definitely got our stair stepper ahead of us. A couple old men keep on trucking though. Our mystery ramp just on the other side of this pass we're fixing to get up. If nothing else, we'll have a nice spot for lunch. Up, up and away. Got ice down in the water there. The weather did change last night to a nice high pressure system, but it definitely got colder. Take a little cold at night for 20 days. Beautiful country. Maybe next year we'll fly a little farther that way. We'll explore some new country. Highs and lows of sheep hunting. Walking down the canyon. Spots of ram or sheep up in this valley up here. Sure enough, it's a ram. So we come running over onto this bench here. Pinion distance, and spotting scope set up. And I was getting all set up right over here with the old Kimber. Nice, we're about 429, 450. I'm up this camel catch up there. off, had the CVS dialed, and ready to pull the trigger, and RJ said, not legal. That's a tear to my heart. Ah, man. That's how it goes. She was pretty watching them all. Gosh dang it. Looks like a nice chute right there. We could have climbed up and got them. Came down the valley to the airstrip to resupply with food. Woo! Thank goodness this year no bear got our food. So we can continue sheep hunting. Unlike last year, if you remember from the video, bear got all our food. We were done sheep hunting. It's very depressing. Got a nice another valley to valley pass loop that we've done in the past and been successful. So that's what we're gonna go do. It's nice. We had a beer apiece when we got back down here. Very nice. We got a couple waiting for us after our hunt. Got some blue sky. Hopefully we can go find a ram. Had an extremely hard rain last night. Let's see Mother Nature even bless us with a little white up high. Beautiful sun's gonna come out for the day anyway. Coming up this valley yesterday, finally found that band of rams up in those mountains right there. There was one we were pretty confident was legal. So we started to make our game plan, ditched our gear, got our packs light, start climbing up there. Wouldn't you know it, they didn't like it or something, because three of them were bedded down before we started. As soon as we were getting ready to start, they got up and moved and of course went higher. So we abandoned that idea because old guys up in that country don't work out very good. Pretty steep and nasty up there. So we kept coming up the drainage here. Found this nice little ledge. That's probably one of our better camp spots right there. No rocks, nice soft ground. Filming RJ doing some filming. Of course, this morning we got ewes and lambs again up there, but last night we did see one young boy up there. So hopefully we can go find his grandpa. We've been in this country before. There's a pass up high here. It's kind of our goal today. That goes into another drainage. We took a pretty nice ram out of there, I think about 4 years ago. With any luck, we can repeat it. Walking down this creek here, about 4 miles back down to the strip, piece of cake. Let's see what happens. Just nice that it stopped raining.
Day 9. Boys finally get lucky. We're just fixing to almost give up as the fog was coming in. Get to the pass there and finally just set and commit it. Up there and see what we got. Started putting on our packs. But you know it, the set of horns came right through the saddle. Kind of caught us off guard. Scrambled for our binoculars. We didn't have anything on or nothing. We were just lacing boots, getting ready for the last climb. And got our binocs. RJ ranged it at 425. But you know it, six other came with them. So we had our band of seven.
Because we got to go way up there to get back to camp, but that's...
That's what we're going to do is hump them up and over. About a 4 mile downward walk to the strip.
Easy peasy.
Boys got a couple beers down there waiting for us. Guys will be happy to have some Dall sheep filet mignons on the barbecue. Valley's been very, very good to us. Drainage, actually.
our secret drainage.
Shows by the time we get back to the strip, we'll be right at about 45 miles total. Who knows how many thousand feet vertical. I guess that's just what it takes sometimes. You're starting to get a little down after about day 7 and hard rain last night.
Snow.
Had some snow up high. So just gotta keep on trucking because you never know what's around the next bend. In our case, beautiful Dall sheep.
Took a couple hours to process our sheep. We contemplated on pulling it to the bottom, do it on the flats, but glad we didn't. That added another 100-150 steps to our climb up this chute here to our pass, get back into our strip. The other alternative was going down this drainage, which we did on our first sheep in here, 8 miles to the strip. Thought better of that and just pumped it up this. A little grueling, but not too bad. Thank goodness it's all downhill to the strip now. 3.5-4 miles. Not too bad. Mother Nature is pretty nice to us today. Actually quite a nice temperature. Not too sweaty climbing the big pass. Our camp's down in there where the canyon kind of starts. Not too bad. We had a nice encounter with ewes and lambs this morning. It's kind of foggy. Kind of thinking maybe it was over. This is right where the rams showed themselves. We were kind of just right down there. Wouldn't you know it? It just worked out. Day 9. A little heavy with some sheep meat, a cape, and a set of horns. Put a smile to your face. We had a nice hike out this morning. Up and at 'em early. We were both dreaming of a shower and a cheeseburger and see our lovely wives and RJ's kids. I think the GPS said about 4 miles out our Ram Alley. Pretty easy walk and really though, nice creek, no waterfalls. Didn't have to get up on a tundra bench, no bushwhacking. Pretty nice. Got home to beer. Had some beer at the strip. We're all packed up. We just talked to our buddy with the plane. On his way over to get us. I'm taking a shower here momentarily. I'm not gonna lie, but the beer is pretty good. Nice 10 days in the mountains. Another nice successful sheep hunt.